Welcome to Brainstorm It, Solo Build It's smart keyword research and analysis tool. Together with the action guide, Brainstorm It sits at the heart of your online business success. Why? Because it helps you find your perfect business niche, not too broad, not too narrow, with high income potential, and of course, in line with your interests. Let us show you how Brainstorm It works with a real-life example. Meet Maggie. She's just started her online business journey with Solo Build It. She loves anything to do with gifts, so she wants her business to be within that area of interest. But gifts is extremely broad and competitive, so she fires up Brainstorm It to help her find her Goldilocks niche. In her first brainstorming session, she uses the seed generator brainstorm. This function brings back potential winnable niches, also called site concepts, within the broad area of gifts. It could be topics like gift baskets or holiday gift ideas. Rather than guessing, let's enter gift into the tool and see what it brings back. When Brainstorm It has finished its work, Maggie lands at the so-called master keyword list. This is where she sees all resulting keywords and can analyze and filter them in various clever ways. To find potential site concepts, Maggie starts by filtering the results for the term gift, so that she only sees phrases that include that seed word. Next, she filters value demand to be greater than 2,000. Value demand tells you how many people are searching for a particular keyword or phrase. You want to find a topic that enough people are actively looking for. Otherwise, what's the point writing about it? Next, we'll trim the real supply to be less than 100,000. Real supply tells you how many sites exist about a particular topic. The higher this number, the more competitive the niche is. A nice sweet spot area if you plan to start your online business part-time, say 2 to 10 hours per week, is a site concept keyword with real supply in the 20,000 to 60,000 range. Now, Maggie can sort her list by demand, supply, or profitability. Profitability is simply the demand divided by supply as a ratio multiplied by 1,000. The higher this number, the better. As Maggie reviews her filtered list, she begins to note some phrases that are clearly related and might be good potential concepts for her business, such as gourmet, basket, and baby. For any phrase, Maggie can click on the Google or Bing icon to see the results of that search firsthand. You can also click on the site info and get more detailed information about some of the top existing results for additional research. This helps Maggie understand whether she truly wants to tackle this niche or not. After some more sorting and filtering, Maggie has narrowed down her top choices for her online business to unique gift, gift idea, and unusual gift. Now it's time to dig deeper and compare these three possible site concepts. She deletes all keywords, then goes back to the Brainstorm It tool and selects Vertical Brainstorm, Site Concept Finder. Next, she enters her three chosen potential site concepts and starts the search. As you can see, the new list has hundreds of keyword phrases, all containing different combinations of the terms Maggie had entered. Again, Maggie starts by filtering for keywords with a demand higher than 2,000. See the total number of keywords? This helps you see quickly which of the three potential site concepts gives you some breadth. Remember, the goal is to find a topic that's in demand but not too competitive. Look for keywords related to the seed word. 2 to 3 should be over 1,000 value demand, and 10 or more with value demand in the hundreds. Let's check the gift idea seed word. Value demand is over 2,000. That's good. Next, we'll check for related keywords greater than 1,000 value demand. Excellent. Lots of keywords here. Finally, let's check for related keywords in the hundreds. Maggie uses a range to check this. The keywords she sees are all good for writing content for key holidays or life events. For example, Valentine's gift ideas, Christmas gift idea for Dad. The gift idea site concept fits the guideline for a niche that's not too narrow. Maggie moves on to the next potential site concept, unique gift. Its value demand fits the over 2,000 guideline as well. Next, she checks the other related keywords and their value demand. Remember, we're looking for a number of keywords with value demand greater than 1,000. Our goal is to find at least 2 to 3 of them. Fabulous! Great keywords here. Unique wedding gifts, unique Christmas gift, unique gifts for women. And now, to find related keywords in the hundreds, we're looking to see there are at least 10 to 20 keywords in this range to give our site depth. Great! The value demand guideline works for this potential site concept as well, as there are over 100 keywords in this range. Maggie's excited. Two of her potential niche ideas are looking great. She repeats the same checks for unusual gift. The value demand is not as high as the other two, even though it is over the 2,000 demand guideline. When she filters for demand greater than 1,000, the number of keywords and variety of topics are low. So let's adjust the value demand range and get an indication of real depth. Keywords with demand in the hundreds. Nope, Maggie's not confident this site concept has the breadth and depth she needs to build upon. But before she rules out the unusual gift site concept completely, she needs to check a few more things with all of her potential site concepts. So far, we've focused on the demand side to make sure that our site concepts aren't too narrow. Now, we need to check if there's just the right amount of competition. To do so, Maggie removes the value demand filter and sorts the keywords by real supply from highest to lowest. Remember, the higher the supply number, the more competitive a term is. We are looking for winnable depth. If there's very little competition, it probably means that there's no money to be made in this market. But if the supply numbers are too high, Maggie would have a hard time winning in this niche, especially as she can only work part-time on her business. To analyze the winnability of her niche concepts, she sets the supply range between 50 and 500, then checks each site concept keyword in turn. Gift idea. Unique gift. Both of these potential site concepts have lots of winnable keywords. Finally, unusual gift. Not as many keywords, plus the topics are quite broad. In fact, some of the keywords are so closely related, there's probably only 4 or 5 truly unique topics to publish content around. The supply check confirms that unusual gifts is a narrow niche with little potential. So, there's just 2 contenders left, gift idea and unique gift. Maggie really likes the unique angle because there's opportunity to research and find unique items. Plus, it would allow her to target a more affluent audience. She can also sprinkle in some of the idea keywords like unique gift ideas or unique gift ideas for women, but without having to write just about ideas. Maggie's made her decision. Unique gift will be the site concept. It fits within her available time, knowledge, and passion. There are lots of monetization opportunities, but that's the topic for another video. Throughout her business building journey, Maggie will continue to use Brainstorm It. It has lots of additional functions like lateral brainstorms, which uncover topics related to unique gifts, but that don't have the term in them. And Blueprint It, which helps her to organize all her topics and subtopics into a logical structure directly within the tool. What idea would you love to turn into a profitable online business? Solo Build It includes all you need. Awesome tools like Brainstorm It, the step-by-step action guide, world-class support, and a super helpful community of fellow solopreneurs. Why don't you take a first step and subscribe to our free email course to awaken the solopreneur in you? Just go to sitesell.com/solopreneurship to get started.